superstars will be next in line to challenge Randy Orton for the World Heavyweight Championship. Oh, and they're all going after Mark Henry. Everyone was going after the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Tell you, Mark Henry is on the tab, man. Who's going to stop him?
Mark Henry is sizing up Khali.
And now the great Khali.
Oh, look at that, look at this. Look at Mark Henry.
Did you got to be kidding me.
And his path of destruction continues. Henry is not eliminated. He went under the bottom rope.
Oh.
What a move by Sheamus. Mark Henry's assaulting everybody that's being eliminated in this battle royal.
Sheamus has been eliminated.
Did you see that?
We're down to two men, Mark Henry and Sin Cara.
Oh, and there, the world's strongest slam from Mark Henry.
You gotta be wondering what's going through Randy Orton's mind to see the destruction and the dominance that Mark Henry caused here tonight.
That's fair.
Gentlemen, what a main event tonight. It is a return match from SummerSlam. Two of WWE's most physical stars, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, Great White Sheamus, go one-on-one tonight. A SummerSlam rematch to headline SmackDown.
Circumstances. Teddy Long isn't going to be able to make it tonight. So the new COO of the WWE, Triple H, thought it might be a good idea and appointed me the special guest general manager of SmackDown tonight. Another first is going to be this Tuesday. A new Super SmackDown Live is going to take place with the superstars from SmackDown and the superstars from Raw on one Super SmackDown special live. And you want to know the best part? The best part is going to be the main event. Number one contender, Mark Henry, is going to take on Randy Orton for the World Heavyweight Championship. And that's what I'm looking forward to.
Oh, thank goodness. The former World Heavyweight Champion, and to the best of my knowledge, Booker, I don't think anyone has seen or heard from Christian since SummerSlam.
You're right about that, but I'm going to tell you something. Christian always has something to say. Right now, we're in Canada. What should you expect, Josh?
Hold on 1 second there, Brett. I just want to make something perfectly clear, not just to you, but to the entire world. You see, it wasn't my fault that I lost at SummerSlam. I blame one person. I blame one person for my loss at SummerSlam. And that person is your friend, Edge. You see, I couldn't concentrate. After the things that he said to me, it distracted me and it cost me the World Heavyweight Championship. Now, as far as tonight goes, everybody seems to be really excited that you're the special general manager for SmackDown. But let's not forget one little thing. As the former World Heavyweight Champion, I'm entitled to an immediate rematch. That's right. I get one more match. And I want that match this Tuesday, live on SmackDown, my friend.
Well, you know, the one thing I've noticed is you don't listen to your friends very well. Because at SummerSlam, Edge gave you the best advice anybody could give you. Stop being such a crybaby. You're starting to become an embarrassment to your friends. You're starting to become an embarrassment to your family. Starting to become an embarrassment to the WWE Universe. You're starting to become an embarrassment to the world title. And you know what? Worst of all, you're starting to become an embarrassment to Canada. So you know what? Do everybody a favor, but most of all, do yourself a favor. Grow a set of jennies and be a man. Start at the bottom and work yourself back up to the top like a man. Ooh.
Stop embarrassing myself, huh? That's what you want me to do? Let's talk about embarrassing then, huh, Brett?
Go ahead, shoot.
All right. Embarrassing is guys like you and guys like Edge not being able to cope with the fact that when your career is over, it's really over. I mean, look at you. You stand out here in your leather jacket with your greasy, stringy, long hair like you're 25 years old. Let it go. It's over. And you know something else? Maybe you need to hear this, and maybe Edge needs to hear this too, so I hope he's listening. As far as the WWE goes, maybe the both of you can't stand the fact that I'm the only Canadian that's still relevant.
Wow.
But I figured you might act like this. It seems you have the same business acumen as Teddy Long. So I brought something with me. Just hold on 1 sec. You might want to read that. You know what that is, Brett?